Welcome to another episode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Joni here, the teardrop nanny. We'd like to say hi to all of those redwood rendezvousers attending a trailer and teardrop gathering here in the northwestern California redwoods.
There was a 1937 pre-World War II fully restored teardrop for sale.
How about that trailer that was also a boat?
That was incredible, too. The top came off and you turned it over and it was a boat. Today, we're going to be doing braised beef short ribs. Stay tuned. First thing we do is we heat up the pot until it starts smoking. Then we'll put the oil in, heat that up, and we'll sear the short ribs. We've got all the sides seared. Now we'll start on the second batch. All right, I've got the last sides of the second batch searing right now. This is a high and hot operation, but we'll be glad later on when we switch to low and slow with briquettes on the Dutch oven table. First, we need to make some sauce. We've reduced the heat. Now we're going to add the onions, the carrots, celery, and the garlic. And now's a good time to scrape the bottom and start picking that black particulate matter into the food. It's full of flavor. We're going to add a quarter cup of tomato paste. We're going to add a quarter cup of flour. Half a teaspoon pepper. And now we got to stir this constantly until this flour is all absorbed. Now we're going to add the wine, 2 cups. Now we're going to stir this around a bit. We need to reduce this wine. And as you can see, it's thickening up. That's what we want. All right, I like where that's at. So we're going to add the salt pork. Get that stirred in. Now we're going to return the short ribs to the pot. We actually want the bones down. And I took the orange and cut both ends off. That's going to become orange zest in the garnish. And then I slice the rest of the orange up into quarter inch slices and quartered them. So now we're going to add the beef broth. And we have to add enough to keep the ribs submerged. And I can turn the heat up. That looks like it was a full 4 cups. And as soon as this comes to a boil, we can shut this off and move this operation over to the Dutch oven table and begin my favorite part, the low and slow, 4 hours. I'm going to put in the bay leaves, and I'm going to put in a couple of sprigs at a time. It's coming to a boil, so now I can put the lid on it. We can turn this off and move over to the charcoal table. The short ribs have been moved over to the Dutch oven table. It's going to be low and slow for the next 4 hours. 10 briquettes on the lid, evenly spaced. 4 briquettes under the oven, evenly spaced, underneath the wall. We'll change coals every hour. The short ribs have been on for 4 hours. We've done 4 coal changes. And now I need to take the lid off to remove the bay leaves and the thyme sprigs. There's one. Did you find a thyme sprig? One more time, sprig, and one more bay leaf.
It's okay, don't worry.
I know.
It's gonna keep breaking.
Yeah. Well, it'll turn up. There it is. That thyme sprig will become self-evident.
Dean has his over mashed potatoes. I have mine over smashed boiled potatoes. Looks beautiful.
Now that looks delicious. We hope you enjoyed today's webisode. I'm telling you, low and slow, it takes patience, but it's well worth it.
That was a stick-to-your-ribs kind of meal.
We got a surprise coming up, so keep watching.
Yes, and I want to say to Roy and his lovely wife, Courtney, thank you for making this special moment of our event possible.
Yeah, thanks,
I surprised Dean with a vow renewal ceremony, and Reverend Roy married us over at Lake Shasta, and we reaffirmed our vows this time with a host of others who helped pitch in and make it quite a surprise.
We do, again. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
And until the next time, happy trails to you.